In the cocaine capital of the world, Colombia, violence remains the dominant law there. Pablo Escobar is the world's most famous drug dealer who rules the country with a deadly iron fist. A dodgy and fierce killer, he scared the Colombian people and made people live in terror. Paulo Black Oddities. The night of his arrest, this video brings you this. But before going into details, we invite you, our dear viewers, to press the like button and the subscribe button and activate the bell feature to be the first to receive everything new, strange, and realistic. Let's continue. Pablo Escobar became so powerful that he was able to control the drug trade in most of South America and even parts of Europe. In 1992, the United States spent $170 million on the industry. During the election of Colombian President Cesar Gaviria in the year 1990, during his election manifesto, he promised to fight drugs, tackle criminal organizations, and extradite criminals to the United States for trial. 250 kilometers north of Bogota in the Medellin region, federal special forces were conducting an anti-drug raid consisting of a Colombian team under the command of a colonel and an American anti-drug detective. Inspector Benja and his team arrived at one of Escobar's houses. More than 400 policemen have been killed before, and when they climbed the stairs to confront a dangerous criminal who did not surrender without a fight, they found he had escaped, always one step ahead of the police. He surrendered himself under the watchful eyes of thousands of citizens and photographers from all over the world. But he asked to be guarded by his own band. The prison should be close to his farm, outside the control of the police, and equipped with all means of luxury. Indeed, the Colombian president agreed. But in the year 1992, Escobar killed two of his guards after suspecting their infidelity, and he continued to run the drug empire from inside his prison, which the government considered too far. Less than 3 weeks later, more than 400 federal soldiers approached Escobar to take him to a hermetic prison in Bogota, accompanied by government officials who had given him an ultimatum from the president to surrender but took them hostage. Early the next morning, Escobar fled with 9 of his men, leaving the two hostages at the scene. It was also in July of the year 1992. A U.S. cyber espionage team arrived in Colombia at Escobar's place using secret technology. As soon as he picks up the phone, they can locate him and catch him. For this purpose, the squad used a private plane for this, and indeed, through calls, they were able to locate it in a corner of the town of Medellin. But the dwelling was an apartment complex with thousands of people, so they backed down. During the 2 months, the FBI arrested 12 people. It confiscated $2.5 million in cash. Escobar became angry and announced that he would reward anyone who killed $1,000. And who kills Colonel Martinez is $30,000. And who kills Inspector Pina for $300,000. The band members were frightened. Police were killed and bombs detonated on a daily basis. By the end of the year, 26 policemen had been killed. A few days later, a car driven by Escobar's followers in the city of Bogota with 100 kilograms of dynamite inside drove towards the Ministry of Justice, causing them to retreat in front of the presence of a large number of soldiers and policemen and stop the car. In April of the year 1993, Escobar ordered another attack on the capital Bogota, killing 11 people and wounding 200 others. The call is monitored to locate him, and minutes later it turns out he is in the shopping mall where the search team has landed. The place was full of customers, but after searching they did not find him, as he was constantly moving. But he kept calling his son. This made them locate him again inside one of the houses. The search squad got there, and when raiding the house he pulled out his gun and opened fire, and police killed his bodyguard. Escobar then jumped out of a window in the street, where he was surrounded by special forces, shooting him 3 times and 1 in the head. This put an end to a 16-month battle. 147 policemen and 117 civilians died, and 180 others were injured. The next day, a funeral was held for him, attended by thousands of poor people from Medellin who still see Escobar as the hero. Despite all these years since Escobar's death, militias and gangs still dominate the drug market. Colombia is the drug capital of about 75% of the world's total drugs. In the end, friends of the Black Oddities channel, do not forget to like and subscribe to encourage us to publish more of this content. Wait for us in the next video where the suspense and excitement and the most dangerous realistic facts